your spirit. The Spirit of God will lead you in three directions. Number one, as Romans 5:5 says, God's Holy Spirit, if you see the Holy Spirit in your heart, as you read in 1 Corinthians 3:16, don't you know your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit and God lives in you? If only you recognize, your life may have many problems, many situations, but the truth will set you free. Romans, as you read John 8:32, the truth will set you free. And the truth is, you are not an ordinary guy. The Holy Spirit is in you. You recognize and build up your life on the Holy Spirit. If you build up your life on the Holy Spirit will fill you with His love, according to Romans 5:5. Once you recognize the love, when you thank God, when you see God's love in you, when you thank God for His love, Lord, you created me as your child. I am your child. Thank you, Father. You died for me, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. You are living with me, Holy Spirit. I love you, Holy Spirit. The more you begin to love Jesus, the more He took care of the people of Israel. He will take care of me. I will have faith in myself. And I will have faith in my family. My family may go through problem, maybe today something, but no, we belong to God. I and my family belong to God. So my God, He who takes care of me, will take care of my family also. Even if we go through any problem, our God is sufficient. God will bring us. Yes, you will have faith in God, faith in you, faith in others. The love of God will create faith. From the faith, a beautiful flower will come. That is called hope. When I have faith in God, faith in me, faith in others, your life will be a life of hope, a life of meaning, a life of blessing. Let anything happen. We have got some problem. Family got into problem. No problem. Because our God is with us. We will overcome it. We will overcome it. There's a beautiful song we sing in Hindi, you know. Honge kamiya, honge kamiya, honge kamiya, ek din, o man meke viswas, pura ke viswas, hum honge kamiya, ek din. Jab humko हमारे दिल में प्रेम है, अब प्रेम से विश्वास होता है, अब विश्वास से धैर्यम, जो कुछ होता ठीक है, प्रभु हमारे साथ है, होंगे कामयाब एक दिन. यस, होप, होप कम्स फ्रॉम फेथ, फेथ कम्स फ्रॉम लव. द मोर यू लुक एट द क्रॉस, द मोर यू रीड द वर्ड ऑफ गॉड, द मोर यू remember the love of Jesus for you, you will have faith in you, you will have faith in God, you will have faith in all that family God has given to you. When you have faith, when you build up faith in God and in yourself and in one another, your family, your life will have hope. And this is what the Holy Spirit gives to us: love, faith, and hope. On the other hand, you are not only God has created you with mud. He has given the Spirit to you. You can look at the Spirit and build up your life in love, faith, and hope. Or you can see yourself as a mud. I am a waste fellow. I am a useless fellow. Nothing will happen to me. If you see mud, you will lose your faith. The absence of faith will bring to you fear, worries, discouragement, disappointment. And that's what the evil spirit wants to do for you. In the absence of faith in you, you will feel like committing suicide. When you don't have faith in others, your life is a miserable life. You have no hope. So your life becomes miserable. In the absence of hope, life becomes miserable. And that's what the evil spirit is working on. You should see only your body. You should see only the world. You should hear only what the people are thinking about you. It's up to you. Or you can raise up yourself to God's standard. The book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 2. Raise up yourself to the standard of God. Learn to think as God speaks to you. Raise up your standard. Yes. When you raise up your standard, you will have love, you will have faith, you will have hope. In the absence of love, you will feel miserable about you. There won't be hope in your life. There won't be faith in yourself. And Satan will tell you, if you have no hope, if you can do nothing, why do you live? Go and commit suicide. Die. It's up to you. Close your eyes for a minute. It is the anointing the Holy Spirit gives to us. When you live in love, faith, and hope, these three together brings you something beautiful from heaven called anointing. Anointing is the overflowing of God's life in your life, that through you, God's life will flow into the world. When you develop the love of God in you, you have faith in yourself, in God and others. From faith, the beautiful flower comes, hope in life. When you trust in God and when you accept the life of God with the hope, God will anoint you with the Holy Spirit. The world will sing the songs, but the man who is anointed will worship God. The man who is in the world, he will speak, but the man who is anointed will proclaim God's good news. Place your hand over your heart. Ask the Lord today to anoint you with the Holy Spirit, that you may continue to live in the love of God, in the faith in yourself and others, and may your life be filled with hope. Worship Him. Lift up your hands and worship the Lord. Both the hands, lift it up and worship Him. Adore Him. God, in His great love, brought Moses. But though you grow in God's love, through the body, Satan can enter into you. Through the world, through the people of the world, Satan can come and try to destroy the love. Now, God showed Moses how much He loves him. I hear the cry of my people, go and save. God gave the power to Moses. But now Moses, who grew in the love of God, when he saw the people not listening to him, he was discouraged. You know what he said? Listen, he said, then Moses said to Yahweh, why have you treated your servant so badly? Is it because you do not love me that you burdened me with these people? Did I conceive all these people? And did I give birth? And now you want me to carry them in my bosom as a nurse carrying the infant to the land you promised? Did I bore them? Am I their father? Why should I bother about them? Let them die. The great servant of God, who grew in the love, faith, and the hope of God, can fall down to the trap of the enemy if you are not alert.